We've heard a lot about Janine's physical adversity in her last years. But Janine was able to transform her agony into song, and I think that represents one of her great triumphs. And okay, she got stricken with rheumatoid arthritis, which is an unbelievably painful condition. But even screaming in pain, you know, she could still be ecstatically happy in the next instant, and still embrace the world with her spirit. And her response to it was to write a song about it. And I think in this song, she triumphs over it. It's called The Mean Old Badger Blues. Used to be a mountain climber, climbed the highest passes on the earth. Used to be a climber, climbed the highest mountains on the all I'm worth. That badger's fast as lightning, moves and takes up lodging in my shoe. They said he moves in just like lightning, moves it through my gloves and in my shoes. His name is Arthritis. I got the mean old badger blues. Wrists and hands, and man, he's on a roll. Badger ran over my finger. Badger drove a bus right over my soul. See my life some kind of funnel, and all my ease is moving down a hole. Nina. If you see me on the highway, see me sort of hobbling and kind of stiff. If you see me on the highway, see me and I'm hobbling and sort of stiff. I just love to punch the badger's lights out, but I cannot make a fist.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for coming out to honor Janine. I met Janine at Dee Dee Halleck's and Joe Covell's house after the 4th of July when we have our Willow Pond poetry reading series. So that's where I know Janine and Andy, and we go hang out in the garden too and do other things with different flowers. So Janine invites me to Eastern Correctional Facility to read a poem, to read some poetry for her workshop. So is the warden of the facility here? Okay, good, then I'll tell you what happened. So she invites me to the classroom, right? And I go, it's this prison thing, you know, I have to frisk myself the night before I go to make sure I have no contraband, you know, in the small of my pockets or anything. So I show up, and they take me to the library, and it's a little room, and it looks like, has all these ducts, these air ducts all over the place. It looks like the movie Brazil. And so I get a little crass in me, and I go, Janine, do those air ducts, do they lead directly up to the warden's ass? And she said, no, not exactly, but close enough, because he heard it. I just thought I'd share that with you. We need some laughter. So I'd like to share this poem for Janine. I didn't write it specifically for her, but I thought with everything they were saying, oh, okay, it's appropriate. It was inspired by Auguries of Innocence by Blake, where he says, to see a world in a grain of sand. So I titled the poem, In a Grain of Sand. And it goes like this. We are star seeds, every one of us. You and me and you, and him and her, and them and they, and those who know of this are truly blessed. True for all living beings, beings living, not humans only, but ants and trees and the open breeze, things that breathe, air or fire, water, earth, all kinds of dust and dirt, particles a part of all a part of everything that is in everything. Thus it sings and its song is life, and life is a seed of stars, the dust of suns and moons, rocks and dust, and outer smoke in outer space, floating in a bath of timelessness, counted, measured, numbered by some species and others caring not. Science and mathematics trying to plot poetry in motion, motion in a helix's curve, and life on Earth becomes visible to you through the naked eye. God bless you.
Thank you. standing by her side to bring the king back his bride. As thousands of years are between them now, they will change it somehow.